Tuesday morning. It's almost noon. We check out at noon. So we went down to the 7-Eleven knockoff place and I got some Lay's, some grilled squid flavor. And we got like four dumplings for 50 cents. Ow, they're really hot. Really good. We're realizing that food is generally pretty cheap here, but everything else is not. Now for the squid Lay's. They kind of smell fishy. They look like your run-of-the-mill barbecue Lay. Sarah keeps saying ew. They taste like barbecue and a little bit of fishy flavor. You wanna try one?
No.
You wanna smell it?
No.
And Sarah got a Kinder Egg, the premier of Chinese cuisine.
They don't sell them in the United States anymore because children used to choke on the products in the chocolate egg.
Oh. What?
There's like the toy on one side and then the chocolate on the other.
Lame.
Any good?
Yeah.
We leave for Chengdu today, and Chengdu is the big panda place. We're not gonna see that for 2 days. Tomorrow we're gonna see the big Buddha and something else.
Our journey to Chengdu brought us to the Sichuan region of central China. Somebody's luggage got damaged when we got there, so we ended up having to wait for a while they got it sorted out, and somehow Despacito karaoke ended up happening on the bus. Chengdu was a lot more of a metropolis than I initially thought. All I really knew about the city was that it was a big panda reservation, so in my mind, that's all that I pictured. The city's in a part of China that is almost always overcast, generally getting only about 1,000 hours of sunlight a year, which totals to only about 80 days out of the year of daylight. Chengdu has a reputation for being one of the most laid-back cities of China. And in addition to the pandas, they're known for their spicy food, particularly hot pot. At our hot pot dinner, they gave us a spicy hot pot and a mild hot pot, which is great because I really love spicy and Sarah is not a big spicy fan.
I tried fried watermelon.
After dinner, we called it a night. The next morning started with a 2-hour drive south to see the big Buddha of Leshan.
Of signs, strong-willed, popular, high aspirations, successful,
but can be a bit bossy.
The Buddha is actually carved into the side of a mountain, so we got on a ferry and headed out to go see it. It was a monk named Hai Tong who started the Big Buddha Project back in the 8th century. It's in an area where three rivers converged at one point, which caused a ton of turbulent currents and in turn a lot of boat accidents and deaths. People felt it was the water spirits that were causing these currents, and so Hai Tong wanted to build a Buddha that would calm the waters. He started to raise funds for the project, and as he got more money, some government officials came to him and threatened to take the money away. His response to that was, "You could take my eye, but you're not gonna take this money." It's said that he actually gouged his own eye out to prove his devotion to the project. So needless to say, the government officials did not take the money and he was able to begin the project. After a lot of on-again, off-again construction on it that included his death and other people taking the project as their own, it was finally completed about 90 years later. The huge amount of stone that was removed from the cliff in the construction of the project ended up depositing down in the rivers, which in turn had a pretty significant effect on the turbulent currents. The building of the 230-foot Buddha did indeed end up calming the waters.
So that's supposed to be sleeping Buddha.
Sleeping Buddha. Yeah, I can kind of see.
I guess that's his head. Maybe that's his nose.
His head over there.
His belly. Or is that his head? Oh, yeah. What is that? If his head's over there, what is that?
Our lunch consisted of some more spicy Sichuan goodness.
Fish is manager, by the way, and we're going to have to talk residuals here.
We then headed a little east of Chengdu to the Huanglongqi village. The ancient town is nearly 2,000 years old, and even some of the roads that were paved in the 15th century have actually been pretty well preserved.
says, our second night in this hotel, the Howard Johnson Chengdu, the last couple hotels have been four-star hotels. This is the first five-star hotel that we're staying at, and it's really, really nice.
Look at what they did to my cables.
We have a really nice view. Got this little couch. Got this little desk that you can't really see. Really nice view of the city. There's the bathroom. It is kind of weird that you can kind of see through there. And really nice tub. Went for a swim this morning at the really nice Olympic-sized pool. Nice tub, toilet, and shower. And this right here lowers it if you need a little bit of privacy.
We headed to bed to get a good night's rest because tomorrow Sarah was going to get the opportunity to cross off her number one bucket list item, to take a picture next to a panda.